tomorrow, keep praying for the sick, the afflicted. We want to keep praying for all the needs that are out there tonight. Pray for the rest homes where there's a lot of this COVID going on. And pray where death has come. There's a lot of people bereaved, people tonight that's bereaved over the loss of loved ones. And then we want to remember the lost. They're in the greatest need of all, someone that's lost and on their way to hell. They need to be saved. Remember our little group that's vacationing, and that God would keep them safe and give them a safe trip back home. And we're just glad to have y'all with us, glad to have all of our visitors with us. Ain't y'all give them a good welcome. And we appreciate you tonight. We're going to start out with a word of prayer, then we're going to do an old hymn, a little bit of it if I can. I'm about horses and frog tonight, but we just thank God for his blessings. Little David, ask God's blessing, please.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful opportunity to be here to give you the praise and the honor and the glory. To have all the brothers and sisters, your spirit, come on in. And Jesus, we pray, and amen.
Amen. The great Recon Day, maybe the QE. There is coming a day when the judgment will go. Hard to reap as it lies with song. Then the eternal will ring and we soul to the flesh. Heaven joys then will never be known. May we soul right to sing for the reaping which is gone.
Thank you.
Go ahead and sing.
Are you gonna go sing?
Yes.
Then go sing.
Will you go ahead and sing it? You want me to play?
Jesus loves me.
Jesus loves me. Okay, go ahead and do that.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
That's good, ain't it? I tell you right now, there's so much truth in that little song, ain't it? This little, I'm glad the Bible tells us, I'm glad we know, amen. All right, Connie's going, you're going to do I'll Fly Away while I come right ahead. What page is that?
333, I can find helper if I got to do the G if I do this.
That'll be fine. Connie, don't care what key you sing.
Let me get my major. Yeah, give me just a second.
It's more.
I have words to do.
Huh? Connie, you need to be on wearing next to the microphone because they can hear me. They don't need to hear me, they need to hear you.
They need to hear both of you.
I may get the board of the course of verse out.
This sunlight morning, when this life is over, I'll fly away to the home of God's blessed soul. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die.
Thank you.
shall see the King when he comes, right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. I believe that he's King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Amen. The next time he's coming as Lord and Savior, right?
Amen.
Amen. He's coming to claim us. Amen. But I'm glad I'm a part of that bride. Ain't you?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. All right. I'll try to get a little more cord. We haven't used that piano in a while.
We got a microphone right here plugged in nowhere. It just wasn't ready to go.
All right, we'll try to get a little more organized around here. All right, anybody else in the congregation? Aaron, are you saying that Kathy can sing tonight?
Yes.
Okay.
He's been promising us a duet for a while, but he just ain't done it yet.
I didn't put a date on it.
No, you didn't put a date, that's right.
Yeah. That's what she said. She didn't know it was a date either when y'all... All right. Anybody else before we get started up here? All right, then. Come on, Ryan Shannon. You don't have one? Wayne?
No.
Senor Charlie?
I know Charlie's got one. I know Donnie
got two.
Probably
three.
Now let's go and get out. Oh,
please.
Amen. Oh, I'm sorry, Tom.
He was trying to get ready to change the channel. It's up there.
Oh,
ahead, son.
Oh.
Praise the Lord. I'm glad that I have gone free, can still go free, that Jesus is there watching over me. How many of y'all feel that way here tonight?
Amen.
You know, there's a lot of miracles that I've not seen in my life. There's been many things I've prayed for and asked the Lord to touch and hadn't seen. But there's one miracle that I have seen that I know for a fact. I've seen others. But the biggest miracle in my life is getting saved. When Jesus took that old rotten black heart and he washed it in his red blood and he turned it around, and when he did that, he gave me a new conscience. He gave me a new thinking. He gave me a new life. And the name of this song right here is "There's a Miracle in Me." Maybe keep E flat. I don't even know I've ever tried to play it on a banjo. I'll see if we, I may ask it. I know it. I know it. That ain't the song that I was going to do. I thought it was there, but that ain't it. It's right here in this thing. So y'all give me just a second. I could have swore that's what that was when I found it in the other day when I was going through it. I said, hey, I've got this on another piece of paper and sit in that book. So this old book's falling apart. So, there what? Oh, Al, yeah. Al's falling apart too.
I ain't saying nothing.
I didn't say it. Wayne said it. I'm just screaming.
I didn't say it. I didn't say it.
Your little buddy's talking, Fergie.
You know, I don't think it's in here, so I won't do it. I'll just do this song. Maybe there's a reason that I need to do this song. This right here is called "There's a Miracle in the Making." And maybe the same key. You know, this song goes true, too. If you'll just keep holding on, God's got something for you. Oh, the cry was great. She knew she had to be healed, for this was her last hope of ever being healed. So she pressed through until she touched his dark blood.
Been heard.
faithful, he is forever true, and he's going to take care of us. Though the whole world forsakes me, I know that Jesus is going to be there with me. Amen. How about this one? Maybe here. Gee, I don't know.
If three men hold a mountain up on Calvary, but the man in the middle was Jesus, he died for you and me. If the man on the left was sinner, tied to the cross and bled, he could have been together, but he cursed the Lord instead. They say, who are the Son of God?
Thank you.
started out as a boy.
Turn with us there. Hope that you will and reverence the Word of God. Pray for us. We're hoarse and tired in body, but that's good. I mean, we ain't been a lot of gagging today, right? Amen. You there? Luke 15. Very familiar scripture starting in verse 17. The Bible said, when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father's have bread enough to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father and say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. Make me as one of thy hired servants. And he arose and came to his father. But when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. Let us pray. Father, I thank you, Lord, that you let us come this way tonight. Thank you for the songs. Thank you for each family represented here today. Thank you for the great outreach that we've had, God, through the testimonies and, God, through the outreach of the Facebook ministry. And thank you for each family that is devoted and dedicated themselves to the worship and service of today. We pray for all the sick now and the afflicted. We pray for the lost, most of all tonight. We pray for this nation, God, that you might speak and move in the hearts of the people. And God, that the mighty power of God might be manifested in the midst of all these things that are going on. Bless us, God, in our humble efforts here tonight. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, you pray for us. We, like I said, a little on the horse side tonight. Been preaching all day. But that's what God has called us to do. I want to talk to you about the road back home. Now, I need you to pray for me on this. Sometimes I think, friend of mine, we allow ourselves to focus on this parable revealing only unto us merely how rapid that the sin brings forth destruction in someone else's life. We very seldom do we take notice of how sin is so destructive within ourselves. We can see everybody else's problems. We can see everybody else's wrong. But we just don't seem to be able to see that of our own here tonight. You know, churches have got in one respect where they're very, they're very judgmental over things when if they look at their own life, they wouldn't have room to point their finger at nobody else tonight. Amen. I'm not talking about the ungodly, wretched things, sin still called sin in everybody's life, but I don't think you ought to look over and stick your tongue out at somebody on the other side of the church if you're not living any better life than they're living. Are you understanding what I'm saying?
Amen.
But we focus so much on the destruction in somebody else's life. And you know, you and I today, if we just look, there's evidence tonight all around us and friend of mine in our own lives that will bring us to the conclusion and the knowledge that there's some repentance needed within us.
Amen.
We need to cry out to God. We need to seek God. These people that are saying they're perfect, friend of mine, there ain't no perfect people in this life. You say, well, I'm a saved. You're just a sinner saved by grace. You're in the flesh.
Amen.
As long as you're in the flesh, friend of mine, there'll be sin in your life. That demands for you to have repentance. Amen. You better be thankful God's grace is sufficient for all of our needs.
Amen.
Where would you be without a God that loved you enough to hear your prayer, that you could touch the heart of God through faith and find repentant power from God that you could be forgiven?
Amen.
Amen. Forgiven. People act like the altar is rattlesnakes. They don't want to never come. I reckon people think if they come to the altar, they're afraid that somebody might talk about them. Amen. They talk about you whether you pray or not.
Amen.
The only thing is you deprive yourself of the blessing by coming to the altar and getting your heart where you need to be with God. Listen, friend of mine, as we look at what we're, this parable, this message that Jesus Christ is talking to these people about concerning this young man. He was found reaping of the life that he had sown. Amen. Yet nobody has any room to complain and bellyache about being in the hog pen when they deliberately and willfully chose that path to walk in tonight.
Amen.
Nobody's got any room to blame somebody else. There's people out of church tonight that's blaming the church. They're blaming the pastor. They're blaming the deacon. They're blaming other people in the church. Let's just bring it down to where the rubber meets the road. People are living the life they want to live. If they wanted to live any different life, bless God, they change it.
Amen.
Right? This young man was reaping of the life that he had sown. He'd come face to face with the consequences of his choices tonight. Amen. Are you listening? People today are laid in the hospitals and they ask themselves why that they have cirrhosis of the liver when they've drank all their life and been a drunkard all their life. Why do they have cancer when they've done all? And you can get this without ever drinking. You can get cancer without ever indulging in the things of the world. But so many people have read on the pack, they've looked on the bottle all their life, and they've been nothing but consumers. And now how they're whining, crying, because the evidence of this is showing in their life.
Amen.
Are you listening?
Amen.
I don't think nobody's got a right to sue the cigarette company.
Amen.
It says right there on the pack what it will do. But somebody found out that they could get a little money greed by suing. Amen. Hey, if there's a sign that tells me the road's washed out and I ignore it and I go on up there and run my car off in the gully, I ain't got nobody blamed but me. Amen. People are living lives today completely consumed by sin, and all the while the Word of God has given us a spiritual directive, but yet we ignore what God says, do what we want to do, and whine and cry and bellyache because we are suffering the consequence of choice.
Amen.
Amen. Our own choice tonight. That's what this young man was doing. He wasn't told to leave home. He wasn't introduced to this lifestyle that he had lusted for in his father's house. Men of mine, that's a credit to his father. He didn't find this sin in his father's house.
Amen.
His father wasn't living that way.
Amen.
His father, friend of mine, undoubtedly had raised this young man right. But listen, you can raise them right. That don't mean they'll stay right. All the Bible says, train them up in the way of the Lord, and to get old, they'll not depart from it. That is not promising you that they'll always live for God. That's promising you that there'll always be some seed that you have planted in their heart. And therefore, there'll be something they can come back to. And if they come back to it and believe, they can find what they need. Amen. There is no, you don't need to discredit some good Christian family just because their children have decided to live like hell. Amen.
Amen.
Are you listening to me?
Amen.
This young man didn't find this in his father's house. We don't know. Or maybe some of his friends had ventured off, and maybe they wrote to him or got word to him about this ungodly lifestyle. And within his flesh, he began to burn, and the lust began to be there as he wanted to go and be partakers of these things today. The world is calling to all who wants to come tonight. Do you realize that? You know, when we're growing up, we all come to a place in our life that we felt like we were ready to step out on our own. But there have been many times we wasn't.
Amen.
Many times we wasn't today. Amen. Where are you going to go when you leave your daddy's house if you ain't got no house of your own?
Amen.
Huh? Amen. There are people today that don't want to abide. Did you know today that people think that you're wrong if you have your children to abide by rules? You should make them come to church.
Amen.
You know that. The government says they belong to them. I'll tell you what, out of all my years, there ain't never been no government come and put nothing on the table to feed mine. So if they ain't feed mine, buying them no shoes or underwear, I feel like I can tell them what to do.
Amen.
Right? Coming to church is a part of our family.
Amen.
If you live in my house, you come to church. If you don't go to church, you find some other house to live in. Amen. That's hard, preacher. It doesn't matter. The world needs to come to that understanding today. What's wrong with the church? What's wrong with worshiping the Lord? What's wrong with getting saved? What's wrong with having peace and joy and comfort in your hearts tonight? Not a thing. Not a thing. This young man was living. Seems like this thing's getting louder and louder, don't it? Seems like it's getting louder and louder, don't it? Amen. My God, if this thing keeps getting louder, I won't even need this Facebook thing. They'll hear me halfway to China. This young man was living the life of choice today. Friend of mine, sin has a way of painting a pretty picture. You never see the destructive side of sin till you have fallen so deep in the rut that the devil hopes you can't get out. I've told you before, friend of mine, I wished I had that horse that Marlboro man rode for 40 years. He rode the same horse, had the same smile, wore the same hat. Amen. Every commercial about ungodliness shows young people have it. That's how come our young people are being stolen today. They've been shown a picture that is untrue. It's a deceptive picture. They do not share them to the hospital or to these places where people's mind has been burned up on drugs or where they're dying in pain. They don't show them that. They show fun. They show a good time. But friend, there's joy in sin for a season. But the season will come to an end tonight.
Amen.
Do you know that? This young man found this out of the hard way today. Friend of mine, it paints such a pretty picture. It blinds the eyes. It deceives the heart. It hardens us from any feelings for others. Sin puts you in a limelight in your own mind. Amen. So many people, they are trying to live by reputation. Amen. Live by reputation. Amen. Just because your family might have been drunkards don't mean you have to be.
Amen.
Just because they were brawlers and looked up in the mind, go out and fight and raise Cain don't mean you have to.
Amen.
Well, I'm just following tradition. Who told you to? Tradition's man-made. It can be broken any time. Did you know that?
Amen.
Amen. You know, I could have followed in the footsteps of some of our family, and Aline can tell you today, but friend of mine, I tell you what, God was good to me. He let me get sick of just seeing people be drunk instead of me wanting to be. Amen. Amen. There ain't nothing uglier than a sloppy drunk. Foaming, slobbering out both sides of their mouth. Their tongue is thick as the sole of my shoe. Trying to tell me something. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. I've seen a lot of good people be deceived by the deceptive picture that sin brings forth today. You say, well, you don't have to tell me nothing. I lived around it all my life. You can't tell me about these things. Amen. If I'd never been around it, you might deceive me, but you can't now.
Amen.
You can't. I watched an uncle of mine race his car motor till he threw the rod plumb through it, and he thought he was going somewhere. Amen. Thought he was going somewhere. I watched them come in, and after us picking tomatoes, us three older kids and my mama in the field, we'd be picking all day, and we had 3,000 and 4,000 tomatoes, and friend, I watched them come in and stagger and tear up 10 and 12. I wanted to rub them maters in his face. But I was just a kid. But as a kid, I had feelings. I wanted to rub them in his face. Amen. Sin is takes away any concern in people's life or anybody else. People today that are proud sinners don't care about you and me.
Amen.
They have no feelings for anybody but themselves. Sin puts them in the limelight in their own life. Then they can't see what they really are tonight. Amen. Sin has a purpose. Friend of mine, and that's to bring, to keep you into bondage until the last breath of life is taken. Sin's purpose is to keep you restrained until you die without repentance in your life. Amen. Isn't that something today? I ain't got nothing against doctors. I thank God give us doctors for a reason. But I got something against these doctors that'll get all these people hooked on these drugs. I got something against them for that. Amen. Have you?
Amen.
It's too easy. It's too easy today. Now they're sending out papers wanting us to sign where do you believe it's okay for people to have marijuana? Amen. Listen, they stopped the farmers from making tobacco, and now they want them to start growing marijuana. I say no. Somebody said, what about for medicinal purposes? That's what they said about whiskey. Every drunk would tell you that a little bit of wine's good for the stomach. Right? And in reality, there's truth to that. Friend of mine, if it wasn't fermented wine, when your stomach is giving you trouble, juice is good. Amen. And that's what God is saying. God's not telling you to go get a quart.
Amen.
Right? Medicinal purposes. I'm going to leave that up to the Lord. But I can just stand on what I believe tonight.
Amen.
Right? Amen. I'm going to go out on a limb. I believe today that we're seeing a lot of this stuff passed because we can see that our government has their nose stuck in everything that's going on in the world.
Amen.
Amen. I like I said, I don't believe in a lot of things, but a friend of mine, I can carry you to several houses that was used to be right around here. They called them bootleggers.
Amen.
Bootleggers. The government, friend of mine, put them out of business because they wasn't getting the money. They tore down the stills, and again, let me say, I'm not saying it was okay, but they tore down the stills and locked up the people making liquor, and then they give a license for people to have a company. Isn't that amazing? We're living in a time today when we're suppressed underneath the thumb of people that think they know what's right for us. I'm still old enough to make my own decisions. Ain't you? I've been taught down through my life to trust God, to pray to God about things. And if God says it's okay, then it's okay. But if God says leave it alone, you better turn away from it today. Right? This young man just was consumed by his lust. Lust starts fire inside your flesh that's uncontrollable. You think you can't live without the things you're lusting for. That's where he was today. Friend of mine, he was following after his lust. Sin will seldom reveal its intent until you've fallen far enough that you feel there's no hope left for you. Sin wants you to feel like there's no way out. There's a lot of people today would get saved if people would offer them God's love instead of telling them there's no hope for them. Amen. There's a lot of people today have been ruled out of churches. Rules and regulations. You got to live like me, look like me, smell like me, act like me. Amen. I've seen some of them dudes. I don't want to look like them, act like them, and I certainly don't want to smell like no perfume factory. All I got to be is what God wants me to be. Are you listening to me tonight? There's a lot of good people that just need somebody to tell them God loves them. To show them that everybody, friend of mine, is not the same. We're not all in the same basket tonight. I told them once before somebody was saying something about preachers. I said, don't put me in the basket with no other preacher. I'm just what God has made me. Don't look at me as you're looking at them. See me for who I am, that who God has made me be. I just want to be what God wants me to be here tonight. What about you? This young man, he fell to the very deceptive power of sin. You know, when you fall so far and you feel there's no hope left, friend of mine, you begin to feel that your life is hopeless and worthless. I like to say life matters. What do y'all think?
Amen.
Life matters. I believe life matters without any color put in front of it. What do y'all think? Life matters, amen. Does that make me a racist? I guess I am then. Life matters.
Amen.
Somebody said, if I had my hands on you, I'd just whoop you. You don't know if you whoop me or not till you try. Amen. Life matters. Aren't you? You know, I won't say this again. There is nothing racist in this book.
Amen.
Hey, are you listening?
Amen.
When the Lord Jesus Christ hung on that cross, it was for whosoever will. Show me any color in that word at all.
Amen.
Whosoever will. Amen. Don't point your finger today and tell us that we're racist because we believe the Bible. That we're racist because we're serving God. Don't tell me that today. Amen. I'm saved because I believe the Bible. I'm saved because I worship God. I have a home in heaven, not because I'm white, but because I am redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ our Lord. Can you say amen tonight? Amen. This young man found himself at the hawk pit not because he was a Jew. Friend of mine, that was the lowest disgrace that a Jew could be, was out there feeding the hogs. But he didn't go there because he was a Jew. He went there because of self-will. He went there because he was hard-hearted. He went there because he turned his back on what was good and opened his heart up to everything that was bad. Amen. He said, "Father, give me my portion." And he had a right for that, or his father wouldn't have gave it to him. It was meant to be a nest egg to start him out in a new life. But he went and squandered it on righteous living. Amen. You know, friend of mine, as long as you're the life of the party, everything's okay. Amen. But when you're no longer the life of the party, when you're no longer, friend of mine, carried around and cheered for, then things get kind of rough. Amen. Amen. All of them people that he had bought their drinks, he had shown them a good time. When he got down in need, he didn't have nobody to help him. He found himself joined to a citizen of the country, and he was feeding hogs today. Amen. When you're down in the dungeons of sin, you feel all alone, don't you? When sin reaches its peak in your life, there's seldom a friend that will care for you. So David said he looked on his left hand, behold, there was no man, nobody cared for his soul. But then he turned to God. I want to say to all today that have reached this place in their life that the devil's got them to thinking nobody cares about them. I want them to look up, because there's a God in heaven that loves them, that cares for them, that wants to save them, that wants to pick them up out of the gutters of hell, set their feet on the rock, and give them the promise of everlasting life. Can you say amen?
Amen. Amen.
Amen. When sin's season comes to an end, friend of mine, in any life, you know what it does? It'll drive you to the cleft of destruction and plead for you to jump off. Wayne, I believe there's people today that would not have took their life if somebody had just been there to tell them God cares. If somebody had just been there to show them that there's a God in heaven that cares about them today. But the devil kept whispering in their ears, nobody cares about you. Nobody loves you. Nobody wants you around. Amen. Until they go to this cliff of destruction and they jump off. They call this young man the prodigal son. And he's an exception tonight. Why? Because he came to himself and realized there was a better life than what that he had fallen into. Amen. You and I are exceptions tonight. Every one of us was on our way to hell till we come to the knowledge of knowing there's a better place to go.
Amen.
There's a better life to live.
Amen.
Amen. Ain't you glad of that? Ain't you glad God can take a bottle out of your hand and put a Bible in you?
Amen.
Ain't you glad God can take a pill bottle and friend of mine, fill your heart with God's love and make you one of the greatest workers in the house of God that the church has ever had?
Amen.
Ain't you glad of that?
Amen.
Amen. Let me go on tonight. Amen. I know I'm slow tonight, but you'll just have to pray for me. Amen. There's a better life that he'd fallen into, and he realized that, friend of mine. He wasn't found where he was, but rather, friend of mine, he'd have to turn around and return to his father's house, and from which he tried so hard to get away from. This young man couldn't wait to leave, but he found himself in a place of life he just couldn't wait to get back. What he needed could not be found in the hog pen. He was going to have to go back down the same road that took him away from his father's house would be the same road that carried him back. Amen. He had to come to a knowledge of his wrong and the error of his ways. He was going to have to turn around. That's where the road back home begins. It starts right where you realize that you've allowed sin to lead you. It starts, friend of mine, where you realize this and you begin to turn your eyes back to God's grace and mercy with a determined heart. You pick yourself up and begin your journey. Now, a lot of people have been led astray and that everything's just going to be hunky-dory and everything's going to be peaceful and everything's going to come back together. On this road back home, friend of mine, a life is not pleasant. Do you understand that he didn't have a ring on his head, he didn't have a robe, he didn't have any shoes, he was hungry, he was cold, no doubt he lost a lot of weight. Do you understand, friend of mine, he left the hog pen looking like that, and he looked the same when he got to his father's house. And then from the hog pen to his father's house was a robe that would take him home, that would require a determined heart, a desire how to keep walking despite every pitfall, every hill, every lie of the devil. But he was determined to make it to his father's house. It ain't an easy road, but it's worth the trip if you'll trust God. Amen. Here tonight.
Amen.
Amen. See, Wayne, things didn't get better at the hog pen, did it? He would have fain filled his belly with the husk that he fed the hogs. And the Bible said nobody would give him anything. Nobody. Isn't that something? He didn't get food and clothes and shoes at the hog pen. He had to make this journey barefooted, cold, hungry. But he knew that in his father's house, everything was going to be all right. If he could just make it home, then his life was going to change. Amen. Friend of mine, for all of us that's had to walk this road in one way or another, we know it's not all sunshine and blessings, don't we? Amen. We know that tonight. This young man came into town having the world by the tail. Everything he wanted. He began to seek the worldly pleasures and feed the cravings of the flesh. A friend of mine, he was leaving broken and battered, hungry, cold, and ashamed. His money was gone. The famine, the Bible said, had taken its toll upon him and he had nothing left. Isn't it sad that we have to get down to nothing before we'll ever look to the God that has everything?
Amen.
Isn't it sad that we keep hanging on, friend of mine, till the last dollar's gone and until we're completely without hope? Somebody said, well, I guess I'll just pray. There ain't nothing else I can do. We should have been praying to start with.
Amen.
Prayer is not the least that we can do. It's the most that we can do here tonight. Amen. It's not what I can do, but what God can do through me.
Amen.
Amen. He was leaving in a bad situation. Amen. We're not told that this young man received any scorn from those that he came in contact with. But what does life teach us? Life teaches that people like to kick those that are down.
Amen.
People, when the people see somebody down and out, they like to kick them. Amen. Like to kick them. They like to talk about them instead of lending a helping hand. I believe in helping anybody that is willing to help themselves. That's my motto. Amen. There's a young man I see from time to time panhandling. And I've been watching him. And then last week, friend of mine, I seen him in the store that he's panhandling in front of buying beer. And I said, well, God, that settles it for me. Amen. I don't mind buying somebody a biscuit, but I ain't going to support their habits of ungodliness and sin. Are you? Amen. Amen. I won't tell you any more than that because you have to draw your own conclusion to these things. Amen. I believe this man was scorned. I believe that they cast this spite at him. Friend of mine, as he was making his way back home, you see, by condemning someone else, people somehow ignore their own personal need. Have you ever seen people that always talking about somebody else and never considering their own personal need? Amen. And we know life teaches us that. I believe this young man received that. Amen. You see, he knew exactly what he had to say, but he just had to get there to do it. He done made up his mind. He'd come to his senses. He had a repentant heart there at the hog pen. But he had to get to his father's house to say it. He had to make that journey today. I don't know if you realize it or not, but there's a great spiritual battle to be fought on this road back home for anybody tonight. A great spiritual battle for us to fight here tonight. Just because you tell yourself that you're going to turn around, that doesn't convince the devil that you're confident that you can.
Amen.
Amen. I believe the devil was fighting against this young man every foot of the way.
Amen.
You see, he'd already had him in the hog pen. What makes the devil mad is to have someone so close to destruction, and then, friend of mine, they turn around and walk away from the devil and go back toward the Father's house. I believe there's a battle on this road back home tonight. You see, he had to convince the devil that he was confident in what he was going to do. The devil knows, friend of mine, what led you into the clutches of his clutches to start with. And friend of mine, and if he can hold you just a little longer through his lies and his deception in hope that you'll die in the process, and he's not ashamed to, he knows that you'll die unprepared.
Amen.
To meet God. You want to know who was telling me the day I got saved that I didn't need to go to the altar? It wasn't God. It was the devil. The devil was trying to keep me from going. God had already revealed that it was my last opportunity. I'd been very rebellious, very hard-hearted. God had already shown me. But the devil wanted to keep me. The devil held me, friend of mine, until I made the first step. The first step, friend of mine, was my faith in believing God could save me. And God helped me make every step after that. But you have to make the first step. You have to prove to the devil that you mean business with God. This young man had to show him. And I believe it was all the way home. We can only imagine, friend of mine, what this road back home brought forth in this young man's life. In his heart, friend of mine, he knew all the reasons why he should go back. But you can believe that the devil was landing on thick and heavy. He probably told him that if he turned around, that he'd have even more than he had. Go even further than he went. But by this time, this young man knew that he was a liar and the father of it today. When you get lifted out of the ruts of this life, why in God's name would you want to fall back again? Amen. Why today? You know, nothing hurts the devil more than to have someone that's at the hog pen of destruction to walk away, willing to face whatever consequence comes in order to achieve their mission to have a better life. Amen. The devil hates you and me tonight. The devil hates every Christian, every child of God. The devil hates you here tonight. If the devil didn't hate you, he wouldn't be trying to destroy you like he's doing today. I'm going to hurry. The devil's relentless in his efforts against us tonight. This young man, friend of mine, just like everybody else, had to be determined to keep on walking.
Amen.
Hey, I've had plenty of opportunities to quit. The devil has told me, friend of mine, out of all of these years of pastoring, he's told me thousands of times, why don't you just quit? Well, told me that in the last 30 years down here many times. Why don't you just quit? Amen. You might say, well, why didn't you? Because I wanted you to be here so I could aggravate you by a cracky. Amen. I wanted to be here long enough to watch your hair fall out like you've made mine. I wanted to watch you get old and gray-headed like you've made me get old and gray-headed, bless God.
Amen.
Last 10 years, you got that one.
You ain't no raving beauty. Remember, turn him over. Amen. Wait a minute. Okay. You know, there's one thing I really think a lot about Owl. He always opens the door for me. And he puts a welcome mat out. And I just wipe my feet and go in and have a good time. Amen. Oh, I love him. Now, you can't tell him that much too much because his head will get so big that his killer bee legs can't tote him, and we don't want him stomping around. Amen. I believe, friend.
He's still got his point.
Well, praise the Lord. This young man had to be determined. You and I have to be determined today. You might say, why didn't you quit? Because God didn't tell me I could.
Amen.
The devil told me I should, but God didn't tell me I could. Amen. Amen. I'm glad I didn't. Amen. The Lord has showed me great things through ministering. Amen. I told you that if I ever get without a church, I'm well qualified to pastor squirrels because I've had some nuts in my pastoring. Amen. Amen. Ain't God been good to us?
Amen.
Amen.
This young man found that God loved him. Amen. He found that, friend of mine, his father's house was still a house of welcome. He kept walking knowing that when he got back to his father's house, and his father's house represents a place of rightness. It represents shelter. It represents love. It represents a place where all of his needs would be met. Is not God still standing with his arms outstretched and telling you that you can have all this today?
Yes.
If we'll just get on the road that takes us back to the right place today. I believe there's a lot of people that's exited God's road. The Bible says the way that leadeth unto life is a straight and a narrow way. Right? And that means tonight, Leon, that we can't live any way we want to live.
Amen.
Are you listening? Amen. To be a Christian means you live a separated life. You can't, friend of mine, be partakers of all these things of the world and love God. The Bible says the love of the world is enmity unto God. Are you still with me?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. These things today, friend of mine, that we see that people are indulged in and they say that God says it's all right. Hogwash, it ain't all right. It ain't all right. The devil has convinced people it's okay, but it's not. Let me hurry and hush tonight. Amen. I'm running out of gas, not running out of message. Amen. I love the Lord. Amen. I come out at 4:30 this morning. I thought, what the heck? Ain't no need to lay in here. The clock's done went off. I have to put it 30 minutes early just so I can talk myself into getting up. Amen. Amen. Y'all don't have to do that. Amen. The worst thing in the world is a snooze button if you get used to it. Amen. So I just set my clock ahead 30 minutes. Amen. So instead of it being 5 o'clock, it's 4:30. So I have 30 minutes to talk myself into getting up. And the only thing that convinced me to get up is in my mind I can smell that coffee cooking. But really, it ain't going to be cooking until I get up and put it on.
I was wondering about that.
I bet you was. Listen, the road back home. It's not a pleasurous trip, but we got to understand that love will conquer all today. His father had compassion on him. He ran to him. Amen. Don't you think that his father had looked down that road time after time after time? Don't you think his father probably watched him as he left home and went over the last hill? And in his heart, don't you think he was weeping inside as he watched his son? You know, friend of mine, he knew where he was, what he was heading into. But he couldn't hold him at home. It had to be his son's will to be in his father's house. As he watched, as he got out of sight, I don't know how long he was gone. But can you imagine how many times his father has stood and gazed down that road to see if it was bringing his son back home? And then, friend of mine, when he was a great way off, his father would have never known it had he not been looking for him to come. When he was a great way off, he saw him and he ran and fell on him and kissed him. Friend of mine, you know what he said? My son that was lost is found. My son that was dead is alive again. And it all happened because his son chose to take the road back home. Amen.
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 There's great joy at the end of the road if we'll just take it here tonight. Amen. You know, I want to say this before we close. There's not a disgrace or shame in needing to pray. Well, I believe we shame God by not praying.
Amen.
I believe when God sends His message, when God's Spirit deals with your heart, when God does all of this to get you to come to an altar, if you don't do it, I believe you shame the very heart of God.
Amen.
You see, God has showed you all His love, but yet you will not accept it today. This young man, a friend of mine, had a testimony the same as Naomi when she went back to Bethlehem, Judah. She said she went out full, but she came back empty.
Amen.
He went out full, but he came back empty. Sin will take everything you got tonight.
Amen.
It'll take your family. It'll take your job. It'll take your friends. Anything you got that's worth anything at all tonight, sin wants. And sin will take it tonight. Did you know that?
Amen.
Sin will take it tonight. Amen. Listen, when this young man got home, the process of healing began. His father told him to put a ring on his finger. That ring was a family heirloom. It represented who he was. Amen. Who he was. He told him to put shoes on his feet and put a robe on him. And then he said, kill the fatted calf. I'm not going to run over there, son. Just rest easy.
You never know.
Amen. You never know. Absolutely. But there was a healing process. You know, his son didn't ask to be put back in the place of sonship.
Amen.
Can I tell you this, and y'all get a song? Amen. It doesn't matter where your child goes or what they get into, they'll always be yours.
Amen.
Always be yours. I'll always be God's. This young man didn't want to be back in this place of a son. He wanted to just be a servant. Just let him stay with the servants and work in the fields and do a servant's job. But his father restored him to his position of a son. God just waiting to lift you up if you'll let Him. God just waiting to touch you in the way you need touch. God is just waiting to heal you spiritually here tonight with whatever the devil has drugged you into. If you'll just let Him. But you got to have a determined heart. Amen. You know, you're in a place tonight, you can, as an example, you can stay in the hog pen or you can get out. But you have to choose which one you want. If you love watering with the hogs, then You just well stay there. Amen. You know, the Bible talks about the hog being washed, and when they turn it loose, it goes right back out and wallers in the mud. It talks about a dog returning to its own vomit. Somebody said, how sickening. Amen. You know why they do that? Because it don't matter how clean you get a hog, it's still a hog, and it does what a hog does. It don't matter how you train a dog, it's still a dog, and it still does what a dog does. To keep a hog from doing what a hog does, then it's got to be something more than a hog. If you're still living the same life you're living, you can't say you've been saved and washed in the blood and sealed by the Spirit, because when God gets a hold of you, you live a different life. You're changed, a new creation. If you're still wandering in the world, get right with God. Can you say amen tonight? Amen. Get right with God. There has to be a change made. And God wants to make that change for you here tonight. Amen. I don't know your heart. I don't know a single heart tonight but mine. Amen. But don't let the devil convince any of you that you can't turn around, because you can tonight. God allows U-turns in our life. Ain't you glad God allows U-turns? How many have you made?
Amen.
How many have you made? How many times have you had to make a U-turn to get back in God's blessed will tonight? Do you need one tonight? Then God will help you to make that if you'll just trust in Him here today. Amen. There's a road back home, but you got to make your mind up whether you want to take that road tonight. Would you bow your head? Go ahead and play. I know I've been dragging droopy,
like a prodigal son,
but God's speaking to us tonight.
I want to.
Do you have a need? Maybe you got a problem. Maybe there's a mountain. There's trouble in your life. Maybe the devil's tried to bring destruction down your way. God's reaching out to you today. Just asking you to take Him by the hand and trust Him. Would you do that? Come on, there's already prayer being made. Don't you need to pray tonight? Ain't there something in your life you need to pray about? Amen. Come on, when God's speaking to you. If that young man hadn't decided to leave the home, he'd have died there. To get up and start the journey. Would you come tonight? We're going to have prayer. Father, I do thank you, Lord, for giving us this time tonight. Oh, there's so much to say about this road back home. We didn't even scratch the surface, Lord. We didn't even begin. But I thank you for what we did say. Thank you, God, for what you've shown me in my life, that I might share it with others and be an example. I'm glad tonight, God, that if we'll call upon you in earnest, you'll hear our prayer. You'll answer tonight according to our need. Touch every prayer that's being prayed here in the church and Facebook land. No, God, just let us be found faithful in all the things you have us to do. I pray we've not been a stumbling block tonight, but God, we've been a help to some heart. I beg you again, Lord, that soul that's nearest eternity that's lost, God, would have their eyes open and they would call upon your name while they still have time. I ask you, Lord, to do this in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. What about it tonight? Like the prodigal son. We've all been a little prodigal from time to time, ain't we? God loves you tonight. Facebook land. May God bless. Good night to these people out there. We're signing off. Amen. Praise the Lord.